because of protests over the death of George Floyd. You're looking at a line of state police who have just showed up on the scene. Overnight, a police precinct close to the scene where George Floyd was killed was set on fire. Police were evacuated for their own safety. Minneapolis police have not been on the scene for all of these hours, John, but state police have just showed up, as have National Guardsmen in Humvees. This situation is very active.
Again, what you're looking at now is live pictures. This is about one block from the 3rd Precinct Police Headquarters, which burned overnight. This is a location of another building that has been on fire all night. This police presence, state police presence, just arrived on the scene, as did National Guard, although we're not seeing them in this picture. This has just been part of what has been an extraordinary night. There have been protests across the country over the death of George Floyd, confrontations between police and demonstrators across the country. And then the president himself weighed in overnight, inflaming tensions, many people say, including Twitter. He put out a tweet saying, "When the looting starts, the shooting starts," which many interpret as a threat to have the U.S. military shoot protesters. It harkens back to the 1960s when the Miami police chief made just such a threat. All right, let's get right to the scene. CNN's Omar Jimenez is on these streets, has been there for hours watching this police presence arrive. Omar, tell us what you're seeing.
Well, right now, this line of Minnesota State Police slowly advanced side by side as you see them standing over the course of a block in unison. And they've been giving out commands, so I'm going to let you listen. And that command we heard from almost a block away as they were advancing. This entire area here was, as of literally 20 minutes ago, filled with hundreds of people. And as you can see right now, there's absolutely no one. What they were on before was, you see this scene here with flashing lights. We have police here and the fire department. They are working on a huge fire that broke out on a building there on the corner. And you see sort of the smoldering aspects of it right there, where when we first got here, that fire in that building burned over the course of at least an hour without being touched by any fire department. There was no first responder presence here as people were running throughout the streets, throwing stuff into the building there as well. And then it came in literally a matter of minutes. Police swarmed the area along with the fire department coming afterwards. And as we were all paying attention to this scene and people were scrambling away from this, we turned around and people said, "Well, who are those people coming down the block?" And that's when we turned and saw this line advancing slowly toward our position. Now, if you look over to the left, you can see what they're standing in front of. That is what used to be the Minneapolis Police 3rd Precinct that went up in flames just after 10 p.m. last night. They had put up fencing to try and keep the protesters out. The fencing was torn down. It was breached. The protesters got in there. And then a few moments later, it was up in flames as people even continued to shoot fireworks into that area. You see it. It is just a charred fraction of what it once was. The mayor made the decision, along with the police chief, to evacuate that precinct based on the safety of those inside. But obviously, this is a situation that has changed very, very rapidly over the course of even just the past 10 hours. Now, when you talk about the National Guard, the mayor and the governor, they had requested about 500 National Guardsmen to come here. As you look at this destruction at the liquor store just across the street from the precinct. And look, we see them advancing here on the right, the state police officers. We're going to get out of their way here as they advance down the block. You see state patrol written. We see state patrol, so they're telling us to leave. So we're going to back up just a little bit. We're backing up as they form a perimeter on this block here. This is part of why we wanted to be. This is part of why we wanted to be on the edge of the block, to give them some room to form a perimeter. But you can see this is a coordinated effort here to protect this area of the city. At one point I mentioned you don't have to look far to see the destruction left behind by some of the protesting that eventually gave way to rioting and looting. And if you look under the stoplight on the left here, you see what appear to be National Guards members. We did see multiple Humvees come through a few moments earlier on a separate street alongside the state police as they were advancing. But this is obviously a coordinated effort from the local, state, and federal level to get back control of this part of the city. And we know that's in the minds of officials here who, including Jacob Frey, the Minneapolis mayor, has been on the side of the protesters for the most part, saying he wants the arresting officer in this to be charged with murder, which is the same rallying cry that we have heard again from the protesters and from the family. Where they seem to draw the line, though, comes from when the protesting gives way to damage to the city. And we heard Jacob Frey in the late evening hours yesterday saying that that cannot continue. And I think we are seeing a manifestation of that idea play out right in front of us here. And so-